Welcome to Hopkinton High School for the final regular season game as the 18-1 Hopkinton Hillers welcome in the 15-3 Bellingham Blackhawks. The Hillers are just one win away from going undefeated in the TVL, and they have perhaps the second toughest team in the TVL to do that against in Coach Dennis Baker Sr.'s Bellingham Blackhawks. It's Baker Bowl Part 2, and this time it is taking place in Hopkinton. We had the first time these two teams met for you here on HCAM in Bellingham. It was a gut-wrenching 3-2 victory for the Hillers, went down to the wire, and once again we have the same pitching matchup, Juliet Hulme versus Zoe Haley. As stepping into the plate is second baseman Megan Cook. She awaits the pitch. First pitch is down low, a 1-0 count to start. Let's take a look at the Hillers diamond. Lizzy Kelley will be behind the plate. Jenna Bogan at first base, Molly Bennett at second, Kate Wilzell at short, Nikki Como at third. We'll get you the outfielders after this pitch as Hulme delivers. And that is up high. Kayla Sullivan in left, Hannah Engstrom in center, Renee Cooprider in right field. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call, just underway between Bellingham and the Hillers. As there's strike one, 2-1 on Megan Cook. And as for the Bellingham batting order, it's Megan Cook, the second baseman, leading off as she fouls that one away. Julianne Kilduff, the center fielder, batting second. Chloe Woodward, the shortstop, batting third. Kelly Corbett is the center fielder, batting fourth. Julia Cadell is the designated player, batting fifth. Caitlin Profit, the third baseman, batting sixth. Windup and the pitch is down low, 3-2. Casey Baker, the catcher, batting seventh. Zoe Haley, the pitcher, batting eighth. Chelsea Farrell, the right fielder, batting ninth. Elena Chambers is the first baseman, the odd man out of the batting order. As a full count to start things off here on Megan Cook, who has been a great player for Bellingham, and she takes strike three. One away. That'll bring up Julianne Kilduff. It is a gorgeous day here for softball. Temperatures are in the 80s. Wind up and the pitch, and this is hit in the air to center field. Engstrom towards the fence, and that's gone. Juliet Kilduff going yard. The first home run given up by Juliet Hulme all season. 1-0 Bellingham. And it is not too often you see that kind of contact with a Juliet Hulme pitch. And that'll bring up Chloe Woodward to the plate as Bellingham gets things started off early. She steps into the batter's box and awaits the pitch. And this is a little fly ball to right field, and it'll drop into the glove of Renee Cooprider. Two away. Now Kelly Corbett will come up to the plate. As the center fielder steps in. Hulme delivers. There's strike one. Julianne Kilduff getting a piece of a ball to give Bellingham a 1-0 lead as she cleared the center field fence. There's strike two. A rare mistake by Hulme, leaving that one hanging over the plate as the wind picks up, and that is fouled away. Count remains 0-2. The HCAM Weather Center reading 85 degrees today. Some clouds in the air, a south wind. There is a chance of thunderstorms moving into the area. We'll certainly keep an eye out for potential disturbances. umpire saying something to Hulme there. Is Hulme set to deal? There's strike three. Two strikeouts in the inning for Juliet Hulme, but she does give up a solo shot to Julianne Kilduff. It's 1-0 Bellingham heading to the bottom of the first. Set for the bottom of the first inning. It's a 1-0 lead for Bellingham after a solo shot by Julianne Kilduff in the top half of the first. As the Hillers set to come up to the plate, Hannah Engstrom, Renee Cooprider, and Lizzy Kelley do up. And there could be some late changes to the lineup, so we will keep you informed. Zoe Hilly set to take the mound for the second time this season against the Hopkinton Hillers. Had a wonderful start in the first game, but just got outdueled a tad by Juliet Hulme. We'll take a look at the Bellingham Diamond after we have the first pitch to Hannah Engstrom. Infield moving in on the corners, potential bunt risk here. And the first pitch is in there for a strike. Haley's battery mate is catcher Casey Baker over at first, Elena Chambers, Megan Cook at second, Chloe Woodward the shortstop, Caitlin Proffitt at third. We'll give you a left to right after this pitch. There's strike two. Kelly Corbett in left field, Julianne Chambers in center, Chelsea Farrell the right fielder for coach Dennis Baker Sr. and the Bellingham Blackhawks, the defending state champions in Division II. Haley set to deliver. And that is on the inner corner, a little too far inside, 1-2. Anna Engstrom always a threat to bunt, a lot of speed around the base paths. And there's strike three. This is going to be a pitcher's duel here today. Lindsay Whittles steps in. And this is on the ground, first base side, and it is foul. So 0-1 count to Whittles to start things off. To the set. That is outside. Actually called a strike there. Checked her swing, couldn't hold back. 0-2. And time called. Catcher Casey Baker will come out from behind the plate to chat with Haley. Whittles the designated player for the Hillers today. In the second spot, Haley delivers a floating strike. And that's out number two. Beauty of a breaking pitch there. Second strikeout for Haley. And now Lizzy Kelley will come up to the plate. Haley would love some revenge after a close game in the first match. Ended in a 3-2 win for Hopkinton. That one inside. Lizzy Kelley scored one of those runs after she reached on an error in the third. On the ground, up the middle, played by Haley. Throw to first, not a problem. A 1-3 ground out. Will retire the side. On the bottom of the first, we head to the second. It's 1-0 Bellingham. Top half of the second inning, it's a 1-0 Bellingham lead after a solo home run by Julianne Kilduff. But Juliet Hulme and the Hillers defense hoping to recuperate and have a nice defensive inning here. As due up for the Bellingham Blackhawks is Julia Cadell, the designated player, Caitlin Proffitt, the third baseman, and Casey Baker, the catcher. Last game of the regular season for the Hopkinton Hillers. Hulme is set to deliver. And she'll deliver that one inside, a 1-0 count. Take a look at the TVL standings in just a moment. Playoff brackets due out in the next couple of days. There's a swinging strike. Hopkinton 17 5-0 in the TVL, 18-1 overall. Norton 15-2 in the TVL, 16-2 overall. Bellingham 12-3 in the TVL, 13-3 overall. As this one is hit, foul, and out of play. 1-2. And then you have a bunch of teams sitting in the middle. Westwood 8-9 in the TVL, Holliston 8-9. Millis is 7-9. All do have a slim shot at maybe sneaking into the postseason. Hume delivers down low. 2-2. And you got Medfield at 7-10. They're likely out. Medway 5-12, likely out. Dover Sherbourne 2-14. Ashland 2-15. Those two teams definitely out. Hume delivers. There's strike three. Get ready for a good pitcher's duel here. And that'll bring up Caitlin Proffitt, the third baseman. The last time that Juliet Hulme gave up an earned run was actually against this Bellingham Blackhawks team on the road. Only two earned, well now three with this one, but her only earned runs all season were given up against Bellingham as their strike one. And if you look at her stats, quite remarkable. And we'll get you those stats in just a moment. Hulme set to deliver. Swinging strike. A .11 ERA heading into this game. 11 appearances on the mound, 11 games started, 10 complete games, 6 shutouts. She struck out 110 batters. Has given up 4 runs, only one of them actually earned. Excuse me there. As that pitch inside. 1-2. So 4 runs, only one ruled earned. Only 16 walks. That's fouled away. Count remains 1-2. These Bellingham hitters, though, are determined, and they have battled good pitchers this season. And of course, they're very well coached. Hulme delivers up high, 2-2. Wind picking up a little bit here at the softball diamond. Hulme awaits the sign. Proffitt back into the box. Hulme deals. There's strike three. 4 strikeouts so far in this game, and now Casey Baker will come up to the plate. It's impressive, though. She's faced 6 batters, struck out 4. To the set, down low. A 1-0 count. Hulme awaits the sign. Hulme delivers up high, 2-0. Hulme grabs the sign and deals down low, 3-0. Hulme deals. There's strike one. 3-1. To the set, down low, and Baker draws the walk. Casey Baker, no relation to head coach Dennis Baker Sr., by the way. And she scored one of the two Bellingham runs in the first time these two teams met. We're gonna have a pinch runner here for Casey Baker. It's going to be Erin Umloff. So Erin Umloff in there as a pinch runner, adds more speed. And now Zoe Haley, the pitcher, at the plate. No outs in the inning. Two outs in the inning, excuse me. Runner on first, there's strike one. the purpose of this game for Bellingham, they're playing for seeding here. They're playing perhaps for another home game as that one's fouled away. And for Hopkinton, they're playing for seeding as well. Of course, in being in Division One, it's more than likely, even with a loss, that the Hillers could get the first seed, but it's not definite. But if you get this win here, it's pretty definite you're going to be that number one seed. And of course, home games absolutely crucial in playoffs, as there's strike three. Juliet Hulme faces four batters, and all three outs came via a strikeout. We head to the bottom of the second, 1-0 Bellingham. Bottom half of the second inning, the 4-5 and 6 hitters due up for the Hopkinton Hillers. Kayla Sullivan, Kate Welzel, Jenna Bogan. And we do have the rest of the lineup for you. There was a couple of changes. Jenna Bogan is batting seventh, playing first base. Juliet Hulme, the pitcher. Jenna Bogan will bat sixth and play first base. Juliet Hulme, the pitcher, batting seventh. Nikki Como batting third and playing, batting eighth and playing third base. And Renee Cooprider is rounding out the order as the first pitch is a ball, a 1-0 count on Sullivan. Zoe Hilly set to deliver as the Bellingham Blackhawks off to a 1-0 lead. That pitch down low, 2-0. And in the first time these two teams met, Kayla Sullivan went deep in the third, a two-run home run, which drove in Lizzy Kelley to give the Hillers their second and third runs of that game. As that pitch called a strike, 2-1. Kayla Sullivan with five home runs on the season. That home run against Bellingham was actually her fifth. Kelly nods at the sign and deals. This is hit in the air, little bloop shot, and Haley makes the catch. One away. That'll bring up Kate Welzel, the shortstop, who's had a terrific season. Welzel, a 354 hitter. And she racks this one in left field. That'll drop in for a hit. Rounding first base, heading to second. Corbett having trouble chasing it down in the corner. It's a stand-up double for Kate Welzel. Good piece of hitting there. And that'll bring up Jenna Bogan, the first baseman. Haley awaits the sign. Haley deals. There's a swinging strike. It was Welzel's seventh double of the season. Haley delivers on the ground, up the middle, played at short. Throw to first is low, but in time. A 6-3 ground out for out number two. That'll bring up Juliet Hulme. Hulme is a 286 hitter. Haley delivers up high. Hulme has scored seven runs, driven in six. Haley to the set. That is just inside, 2-0. Haley, not a strikeout pitcher, more of a contact pitcher. That pitch up high, 3-0. Como due up on deck. Haley gets the sign and deals. That is down low. Hulme draws the four-pitch walk. It'll bring up Nikki Como to the plate, the third baseman. Nikki, a senior, 304 on the season, has scored 9 runs, driven in 12. Haley to the set. There's strike one as Hulme leads off the bag. Wilzell at second, Hulme at first, 2 outs. Haley delivers. Hit in the air in fair territory, shallow right field, and it is caught by Danielle Sarno, the right fielder, for the third out of the inning. We head to the third. It's 1-0 Bellingham. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Hopkinton Drug, located in this historic New England town since 1954. They're a multifaceted store dedicated to providing clients with an array of healthcare options. Hopkinton Drug is located at 52 Main Street. As we are set for the third inning, the Blackhawks coming up to the plate with a 1-0 lead. As Hulme gets squared away and is set to deliver to Danielle Sarno. And the bunt pulled back, strike one. And these two teams this season, it's really going to be whatever team makes the most mistakes, that's the team that's going to lose, is that one down low, especially with this pitching matchup. You saw Hulme kind of hang one over the plate. Well, that mistake was taken advantage of by Kilduff. Home run in the first by Julianne Kilduff. So far, that's been the only run of this game. As that bunt is down and a strike. 1-2. Hulme is set to deal, gets the sign and delivers. Up high, 2-2. Due up is the top of the order for Bellingham. Go back to Megan Cook and Julianne Kilduff. And that pitch up high, 3-2. Hulme to the set. There's strike three. That is strikeout number 6. Megan Cook will now come to the plate. Now one inside. That pitch up high, bunt pulled back, 2-0. Last time Hulme pitched against Bellingham, she had 12 strikeouts in that game. Of course, that was in Bellingham. HCAM was there. You can find the highlights and the full game on our website, hcam.tv. That pitch down low, 3-0. Hulme deals. There's a strike. Three and one. And there is ball four. Cook draws the walk, and that'll bring up Julianne Kilduff. Julianne Kilduff with a home run in the first inning. Has scored the only run of the game so far. And this one's on the ground, up the middle. That gets through for a hit. A single for Kilduff. That'll push Megan Cook to second. Chloe Woodward will come to the plate. Hume set to deal. Outside. Some good speed on the base for Bellingham. Hit in the air, right field, and caught by Cooprider. Runner at second tags. The throw in cut off by Welzel. And there is runners on the corners with two outs. Kelly Corbett will now come to the plate. Hume deals, and this is a liner at the second baseman, Molly Bennett, and a nice play. Good job by Bennett. Gloving that one up and throwing it over to Bogan. That is the third out. Despite two reaching, it remains 1-0. Bellingham heading to the bottom of the third. Bottom of the third inning, the 9-1 and two hitters do up for the Hillers. Renee Cooprider, Hannah Engstrom, and Lindsay Whittles. As Zoe Haley set to deliver, infielders in on the corners. That pitch up high, 1-0. Haley to the set. And there's a strike. 1-1. Haley deals. That's up high. 2-1. For those of you just joining us, you're watching the last game of the regular season for the Hopkinton Hillers softball team. A 1-0 lead for Bellingham. Bob Hamilton on camera. Tom Nappy on the call. And this is a little line shot down the first base line and easily picked up by Chambers as she tags the bag. A 3 unassisted ground out for Cooprider. That'll bring up Hannah Engstrom. It looked like maybe she was going to get some air under that. Then it just kind of plopped down, rolled up the line, an easy play. That's fouled away into the backstop, 0-1 on the lefty. And it has been a tremendous run for both these teams, but especially the Hopkinton Hillers, only lost this year, season so far, came to Milford at the hands of Milford. And this is up the middle, played at short, throw to first in time. 6-3 for Hannah Engstrom. That'll bring up Lindsay Whittles. Whittles struck out her last time up in the first. Haley delivers, gets a piece of this one. That is in fair territory and called foul. And I don't know, did hit the line. Foul called, 0-1. Perhaps got a piece of her foot, didn't have the clearest view from our angle. And pitch down low, 1-1. That actually works out for Lindsay Whittles because that would have been an easy out if that was fair. And this is, we'll take a couple hops on the infield dirt, gets into the outfield, and that is a single for Whittles, and that'll bring up Lizzy Kelley with two outs and a man on. Lizzy Lizzy Kelley grounded out her last time up in the first. Haley set to deal. There's a strike. 0-1. Haley awaits the sign and delivers, and this is foul. 0-2. Push that one up first base side. Haley awaits the sign. Time called as Kelley will step out, take a couple swings. To the set, and it looks like maybe that one slipped out of her hand. 1-2. And you can see the wind blowing the infield dirt around. Very windy day here. This could perhaps be one of the windiest games we've had here. And this is pushed up the left side. That drops in for a hit. Whittles going to third. The left fielder having trouble. She's going to be waved around, and it's a tie game. Lizzy Kelley, an RBI double. And again, that corner on the left side giving Kelley Corbett some trouble. And she might be injured as well in left field. She might have rolled up an ankle. Coach Soderberg down there checking up on her. Coach Baker Sr. going to head down there as well. But there's it's a pretty dangerous drop out there on the left side. It kind of just drops off suddenly. So it is certainly easy ground to perhaps roll your ankle on. And we saw earlier in the second inning, Kate Welzel have a double pretty much in the same exact spot it ended up rolling to. Corbett had to chase it down. She had some trouble getting to that one. And now this one you just tripped up on, but there's a little dip out there on the left side. So when you're chasing a ball down, of course you're not really looking all that much at your footing. You're just trying to get to the ball as soon as possible. It doesn't make it easy to chase it down or stay on your feet. So a little injury break here, and due up for the Hillers is Kayla Sullivan. It is a 1-1 game. Continuing on with the bottom of the third inning, an injury over in left field. Kelley Corbett tripped up by a little dip, chasing down the ball. There's quite a dip out there when you're chasing a ball in the foul territory. And it's very easy to trip on, especially when you're trying to chase down a ball as fast as possible. Lizzy Kelley ended up with the RBI double. Lindsay Whittle scored the game-tying run. It's a 1-1 game, two outs. Kayla Sullivan is due up next for the Hillers. Taking over in left field is Chelsea Farrell for the Bellingham Blackhawks. She will take over for Kelley Corbett, and we certainly hope that Kelley Corbett is okay and the injury is not too severe. Quite a fall she took out there, so most likely just rolled an ankle, but hopefully it's nothing too severe as Sullivan steps in the batter's box and awaits the pitch. Runner on second, two outs. It's Lizzy Kelley over at second. And now Zoe Haley is going to call out Casey Baker, have a little discussion. Kayla Sullivan was voted the MVP hitting-wise of the TVL by the coaches and TVL personnel as their strike one, leading the league in home runs, five homers for Kayla Sullivan. She's also leading in a number of other categories as well. Haley delivers. That pitch is outside, 1-1. Sullivan is second in batting average with a 5.08, first in homers with five. First in slugging percentage at a 915. Haley delivers. And this is a liner. That'll drop into right field as Kelley is going to route third, being waved home, and she will slide in with the Hillers. Second run of the game, an RBI single for Kayla Sullivan. 2-1 Hopkinton. How about that? Kayla Sullivan adding to her numbers as Kate Wilzell will step to the plate. Sullivan also a 574 on base percentage, second in the TVL. Haley delivers. And this is a liner down to third base line. Took an awkward bounce in front of Profit, and that'll get in for a hit. Wilzell is aboard with a single. Sullivan advances to second. That took a very awkward bounce in front of Caitlin Profit, the third baseman, and then kind of rolled into left field. Nice job chasing it down quickly, though, once it got by, as Jenna Bogan steps in, the lefty. That one up high. Haley set to deal. And this takes a couple hops, and it is played by the third baseman. Smart play, getting the force out over at third. That will be the third out of the inning, but not before the Hopkinton Hillers take the 2-1 lead as we head to the fourth. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate, eliminate your pest problem. A family-owned business, call them at 508-366-1820. Find them online at wpcpest.com. As we are set for the fourth inning, a 2-1 lead for the Hopkinton Hillers as they play both runs in the bottom of the third, and quite a sequence of events in that bottom of the third. As stepping to the plate is Julia Cadell, the designated player for the Blackhawks, to face Juliet Hulme. And we'll recap the third inning for you to start things off. It was a 3-unassisted ground out by Cooprider. Engstrom then had a 6-3 ground out. More after this pitch. Hulme to the set, and that is a little bloop shot. Kelley tries to track it down and came to a dive but unable to hold on. 0-1. Lindsay Whittles then had a single, then Lizzy Kelley, an RBI double, which sends the left fielder, Kelly Corbett, chasing it into foul territory. She was tripped up by the dip out there and came out of the game with what we believe is an ankle injury. There's a strike, 0-2. But in any case, Kelly was safe on second with a stand-up double. Whittles came around to score, and then Kayla Sullivan followed through with an RBI single. And then Wilzell with a single, but a force out by Jenna Bogan as that one's fouled away, 0-2. Hulme delivers. That's up high. One and two count. Hulme awaits the sign. Hulme to the set. There's strike three. Seven strikeouts for Juliet Hulme in this game. Caitlin Profit now coming to the plate. Yes, it is Caitlin Profit. As Hulme delivers a strike, 0-1. Profit struck out her last time up in the second inning. Hulme deals. One and one. Hulme awaits the sign and deals. Swinging strike. One and two. Hulme to the set, down low. Two and two. Hulme will throw a good amount of pitches and try to get hitters to chase. That was perhaps an example of one of them. She likes to try to hit the corners as well, especially when she's up in the count. Hulme awaits the sign. And deals, swinging strike. There's out number two. That's strikeout number eight. Coming to the plate now is Casey Baker. First pitch outside, 1-0. Hulme awaits the sign and deals. There is a strike, 1-1. 1-1 count on Baker, who walked her last time up in the second. Hulme delivers, there is strike two. Since the last time the Hillers have played Bellingham, they have outscored their opponents by a lot of runs. We'll get you some stats on that in the next inning as a swinging strike by Casey Baker and Juliet Hulme strikes out the side. On the top of the fourth, we head to the bottom of the fourth, 2-1 Hopkinton. Juliet Hulme at the plate as we start the bottom of the fourth. Zoe Haley delivers, and that is a called strike. So how about this for the Hopkinton bats? Since they last played Bellingham, they've played seven games, and they've won all seven. They've outscored their opponents 82-2. Is that pitch inside? Before that, before they last played Bellingham, they outscored their opponents 108-14. So overall, they have outscored their opponents 190-16 on the season. That is quite unbelievable as Haley delivers down low. As for Bellingham, they've had quite the run as well. Since they last played Hopkinton, they've played five games, and they've outscored their opponents 58-3. They're 4-1 in those five games. The only loss was a 1-0 loss to Norton as that pitch outside. And of course, that was just a showdown, a pitching showdown between Bellingham and Norton, two very good pitchers. Zoe Haley set to deliver. And that is fouled away by Hulme. Kelly Nelson, a freshman pitcher for Norton, is the league leader in wins with 16. And when Norton and Bellingham last met up, it was Kelly Nelson versus Zoe Haley, and what a matchup that was. Hit in the air right side, shallow right field, and it'll drop in front of the second baseman, Megan Cook. A little miscommunication between Danielle Sarno in right field and Megan Cook, and that drops down. That'll bring up Nikki Como. So Hulme safe over at first. Wind up and the pitch, a bunt down the third baseline. A throw to first is in time for one. Hulme advances the second. One away for Renee Cooprider. Hulme at second. Juliet Hulme second in wins on the mound, and let's not forget, she missed the first six games. As that pitch is up high. 1-0. 11 wins for Hulme on the season pitching. But how about this, batter struck out 208 for Kelly Nelson, 110 for Hulme. Hulme still second. despite missing the first six games. Haley delivers, and there is a strike. And I do want to add, Bellingham stats, unfortunately, are not kept on the source, so you can exclude Bellingham from these stats. As that pitch is inside, called a strike, grabs the corner, 1-2. A 2-1 Hopkinton lead, bottom of the fourth, one out, runner on second. Renee Cooprider at the plate as Haley delivers. She chased that one, and there's strike three. That'll bring up Hannah Engstrom. Engstrom over 2 on the day, struck out and grounded out. The lefty awaits the pitch. There's a strike one. Oh and one, Haley set to deliver. There's strike two. Haley gets the sign and deals. Outside, 1-2. Haley to the set. And that's fouled away. Looked like it got a piece of the catcher's pad there. Haley to the set. That is down low. 2-2. Haley gets the sign and delivers. Check swing, couldn't hold, strike three. And that will do it for the bottom of the fourth. The game remains a 2-1 Hopkinton lead as we head to the fifth. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Fletcher Tilton, attorneys at law serving central Massachusetts and beyond with responsive solutions guided by three basic principles, integrity, leadership, and excellence. Fletcher Tilton, visit them online at FletcherTilton.com as we are set for the fifth inning. Two up for Bellingham is Zoe Haley, Daniel Sarno, and Megan Cook, the 8-9-1 hitters. A 2-1 Hopkinton lead. Juliet Hulme back out on the mound is up to strikeout number 9 as she struck out the side in the top of the fourth. She's set to deal to Haley, who struck out her last time up. There's strike one, 0-1. A little bit of clouds moving in. We are keeping our eyes open for a potential thunderstorm this afternoon. That pitch down low, 1-1. About a 40 to 50% chance, they were saying, around 5 o'clock. And right now it's 4:52, so we will certainly keep our eyes open. That pitch got away from Hulme. Looked like it might have slipped out of her hand there. I have to say, I hope I don't jinx it here, but this season we have been very fortunate with the weather. After you had the delayed start by 2 weeks after all the snow really made the fields unplayable until mid-April almost. There is a strike, 2-2. But during the season you've had pretty good weather. Not a lot of delays, not a lot of rainy game days. For Hopkinton, actually, I think there's only been one delay this season. That pitch up high, and that was one of the first games of this season. And if you remember, the softball and baseball team, and in fact, most softball and baseball teams in the TVL all played at Medway to start off the season because they had the cleared off turf field. And that's filed away. And the problem was when these fields did get clear, they were still soaked, still too flooded to play on. But fortunately, that's all over with, and hopefully we won't have to deal with a winter like that for a very long time, as Hulme set to deal to Haley. There's strike three. Fourth consecutive strikeout in a row. 10 in the game. And now Danielle Sarno will step to the plate. Hulme awaits the sign. Hulme delivers, strike one. Sarno struck out her last time up in the third. Hulme deals, there's strike two. Hulme to the set. Inside, one and two. Hulme deals up high. Two and two. Swinging strike blazes that one by Danielle Sarno. Strikeout number 11. Megan Cook at the plate. Fouled away. 0 and 1. Hulme deals, strike two. And this is hit up the middle. Hulme gloves it, throw to first, not a problem. A 1-3 ground out for Megan Cook to retire the side. We head to the bottom of the fifth, 2-1 Hopkinton. Bottom of the fifth inning, the second, third, and fourth hitters due up for Hopkinton as Lindsay Whittles steps in to face Zoe Haley. Infielders in on the corners. First pitch is in there for a strike. Due up after Whittles is Lizzy Kelley and Kayla Sullivan. Haley delivers, and this is first base side, and gloved by Elena Chambers, she'll step on the bag for the three unassisted, one away. Lizzy Kelley will come up to the plate. Lizzy Kelley had an RBI double in the third to drive in Lindsay Whittles that scored the first Hopkinton run of the game. Following that was an RBI single by Kayla Sullivan. Haley delivers, and that is grabs the outside corner for a strike. 0 and 1. To the set. Up high. Lizzy Kelly's had a nice season with the bat as well. A 370 hitter. It's played in 17 games. That's fouled away. One and two. Kelley has also scored 21 runs and driven in 9. Also a 435 on base percentage. Haley delivers, and that one looked like it might have slipped a little bit, 2-2. To the set, and a little bloop shot. It is in fair territory and caught by Haley. Towards the third base side, and there's two away. I'll bring up Kayla Sullivan. Haley deals. And this is a little pop fly, and that'll drop into center field. It dropped right in front of Chambers and a single. And that one fell pretty quick once it got going, and that'll bring up Kate Welzel, and Chambers really had to chase that one down. That was just kind of one of those awkward pop flies. Haley deals, and that's outside. 1-0. Welzel 2-for-2 on the day. Double in the second, a single in the third. Haley set to deal. Up high. 2-0. And it looks like they are going to call Kayla Sullivan out at first. She stepped off the bag and Chambers laid a tag on her. So they're going to say the runner got picked off. So that will be the end of the fifth inning. And we will head to the sixth. This game has been interesting. 2-1 Hopkinton. All right, so to clarify what happened on the bottom of the fifth, Kayla Sullivan hit a single, and she was at first base. And what happened was she took a lead after the pitch, but then never retouched the bag before the next pitch. And in softball, that's automatically an out. So she was called with the pickoff off of first base. So now Bellingham back up to the plate. And it's Julianne Kilduff, who's having a great day. 2-for-2, and she pops that one up. She also has given Hopkinton their only run of the day, a home run in the first, a single in the third. Bellingham, their only run of the day, excuse me. Home run in the first and a single in the third for Chloe Woodward. Hume delivers their strike two. Eleven strikeouts so far for Hume. Down low. 1-2. So that's certainly one of the different rules between softball and baseball is you're not allowed to lead or you have to touch the bag between every pitch. And that is popped up and caught by Hume. Well, in baseball, you certainly have to touch the bag between every pitch as well, but softball, you're not even allowed to lead off the bag until the pitch is thrown. So Chloe Woodward now up to the plate. Hume deals down low. 1-0. This game's had a little bit of everything so far. Another great battle between the Bellingham Blackhawks and the Hopkinton Hillers. A swinging strike there. 1-1. Woodward 0-for-2. And that's up high, 2-1. Hume awaits the sign. Hume deals. And there is ball three. Down low there. Good turnout for this one. Last regular season game of the season for the Hopkinton Hillers. And of course, they will advance to the playoffs. Fighting for seeding with this one. Is their strike two. A very good opportunity to get the number one seed in Division One. And also fighting to go undefeated in the TVL. It would be the first time in recent history the Hillers go undefeated in the TVL if they're able to win this game here today. Hume deals. And contact made. It is going to roll foul. Hume waits it out, and it'll roll beyond the line. Count remains full. Hume set to deal. And this is hit in the air towards right field. Cooprider under it and will make the catch. Two away. And now coming up to the plate will be Chelsea Farrell, the left fielder who took over for Kelly Corbett when she got hurt. First pitch is a strike. And of course, Farrell took over for Corbett after Corbett seemed to have rolled her ankle chasing down a ball in foul territory. There's strike two. Of course, it landed in fair territory and rolled foul. She had to chase it down in the left field corner. That was the RBI double by Lizzy Kelley back in the third, which scored Lindsay Whittles. Hume delivers, and this is a push over to Molly Bennett at second base. Throw to first, not a problem, as Farrell goes 4-3. That is the third out of the top of the sixth. Hopkinton up 2-1, heading to the bottom of the inning. Fifth, sixth, and seventh hitters due up for Hopkinton in the bottom of the sixth. Kate Wellzell, Jenna Bogan, and Juliet Hume to face O'Haley, who has pitched another gem for the Blackhawks, but Bellingham finds themselves trailing 2-1 as Wellzell steps in to the right-handed batter's box and awaits the pitch. And she will crush that one foul. 0-1. That's long gone in the woods somewhere. Some clouds moving in, covering up the sun a little bit. It'll certainly help the outfielders today, as they've had a battle of the sun for a good portion of this game, and that one is fouled away. 0-2, heads up. And the five times Dennis Baker Jr. and the Hopkinton Hillers have met up with Dennis Baker Sr. and the Bellingham Blackhawks, it's been a one-run game. This is the fifth time, and so far it's a one-run game, and that breaking pitch had Wellzell fooled. There's strike three. And I don't know if she just thought she could poke that one maybe into the outfield, but some pretty good movement. And now Jenna Bogan will come to the plate. That pitch almost looked like it slipped. And this is hit in the air, out of play. 0-1. Say that strike three pitch on Wellzell was almost like a knuckleball in softball. So home plate up, we'll dust off the plate. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call. It's been a terrific game between the defending state champion Bellingham Blackhawks and the Hopkinton Hillers as that one's hit into the woods foul. Hillers, they made a nice playoff run last season. Unfortunately, you'll never see these two teams meeting up in the playoffs. Bellingham in Division II, Hopkinton in Division I. Although that could change very soon if both these teams keep up the great seasons they've had. As that pitch down low. 1-2. It was up to me, I'd throw everybody in a one big bracket, regardless of school size. Makes it interesting, that pitch down low. 2-2. Haley awaits the side. And delivers. And that is just low, full count. 3-2 on Jenna Bogan, who's 0-2 so far today. He's had a pretty good season at the plate. Takes that one low and will draw the walk. Jenna Bogan's a .481 hitter on the season. She also has a pair of home runs, and we're gonna have a pinch runner for Bogan as well. A .500 on base percentage for Bogan. And into the game, it's Isaiah Holden for Hopkinton. Isabel Holden, the pinch runner. Providing some speed on the base paths for the Hillers as they try to get some security here. Juliet Hulme at the plate. Infielders in on the corners. There's a strike. Hulme with some good speed down the line, certainly a bunt threat. And Isabel Holden, a big threat to take off. Haley deals up high. One and one. Haley to the set. Swinging strike, blazed that one by her. One and two. To the set. Strike three. That was some serious velocity on that pitch as Como will come to the plate. Two outs, runner on. That's down low. And I think the top of the seventh, especially if Bellingham gets out of it here, could be a little bit tense with a 2-1 game. To the set, up high. Two and oh. Almost had a pretty good season at the plate as well. A 304 hitter coming into this game. That one down low, 3-0. Como has scored 9 runs, driven in 12. To the set, up high, and she draws the 4-pitch walk. Second walk of the inning for Zoe Haley. Jenna Bogan, or excuse me, the pinch runner, Isabel Holden pushes up to second. Renee Cooprider coming to the plate. Haley gets the sign and deals, and this is pushed into right field. That'll drop in for a hit. Holden being waved around, coming to the plate. The throw not in time. It's 3-1 Hillers. A great piece of hitting by Renee Cooprider. A little push into right field gave Isaiah Holden the perfect opportunity to come around. Como advances to third. We have a pinch hitter at the plate. Bree Mirabli is going to pinch hit for Hannah Engstrom. So Bree Mirabli will head to the plate. She'll be your likely Hillers starting pitcher next season. Also a pretty good hitter. She's hitting 13 games, a .407. At the plate, has scored 7 runs, driven in 10. to the set. It's fouled away. And funny enough, with the seven appearances that Mirabli's made on the mound, she qualifies for TVL stats and ERA, a .48 in seven games. Haley delivers, fouled away. Cooprider will get back to the bag at first. Como at third, Cooprider at first. Haley deals. There is strike three. The Hopkinton Hillers, though, they do plate a security run, and it's 3-1 heading to the seventh inning. Bellingham down to their final three outs. 3-1 Hopkinton, Bellingham down to their final three outs as the Hopkinton Hillers just three outs away from having an undefeated season in the TVL. Julia Cadell, Caitlin Prophet, and Casey Baker do up for the Bellingham Blackhawks as Cadell will step to the plate. She's 0-2 so far, has struck out twice. And the clouds are moving in. You can hear thunder off in the distance. The Hillers hoping for a speedy three outs here before that storm moves in. And that pitch is down low, 1-0. Hillers 17-0 in the TVL, 18-1 overall. Three outs away from completing the season, 18-0 in the TVL. There's strike one. And then after this game, the Hillers can get ready for the playoffs. As that pitch inside, 2-1. And no matter what the outcome is, they will certainly be in the postseason. But this game could also mean a number one spot, the difference of having a number one spot and not. There's a chance they get it even if they lose this, or they're not able to hold this lead. But this game will definitely, more than likely, secure that number one spot. Unless something absolutely crazy happens. 3-1. There's strike two. Full count on Cadell. Hulme to the set. There's ball four. And the lead runner is on for Bellingham. Caitlin Prophet coming to the plate. The tying run at the plate. Hulme to the set. Fouled away, 0-1. There's strike two. The throw down to first. They almost got the runner, but she slides back safe. Only two hits in the game for Bellingham so far. To the set. Strike three. One away. Up to the plate is Casey Baker. There is strike one. To the set, fouled away. 0-2. Hulme is set to deal. There's strike three. Two away. Thirteen strikeouts for Juliet Hulme in this game. We have a pinch hitter for Bellingham. Hulme is set to deal. And this is a slice foul. Elena Chambers at the plate. Bellingham down to their last two strikes. One and one. Hulme awaits the sign. Hulme delivers. Strike two. Down to the final strike. Strike three! Juliet Hulme gets all three outs in the seventh via strikeout, and the Hopkinton Hillers go undefeated in the TVL. 18-0 in the TVL, 19-1 overall to conclude the season. And what a job by Juliet Hulme. The lead runner, Julia Cadell, gets on base with a walk and then three straight strikeouts. 14 Ks overall for Juliet Hulme. She goes the distance all seven innings, giving up one run on two hits. The Hopkinton Hillers, they plate three runs on six hits and get a very impressive victory. Juliet Hulme, once again, getting the best of Zoe Haley in a terrific pitcher's duel. Another terrific meeting between the Hopkinton Hillers and the Bellingham Blackhawks and Coach Dennis Baker Sr. and Coach Dennis Baker Jr. And now the Hopkinton Hillers can get ready for the postseason. They'll likely have the number one seed as they finish 19-1 overall, 18-0 in the TVL. A tremendous game, and both these teams will be heading to the postseason. And we certainly wish the Bellingham Blackhawks the best of luck in Division II. And we hope the Hopkinton Hillers will advance far, and we'll certainly be following them here on HCAM every step of the way. But that is going to wrap it up for this broadcast of Hopkinton Hillers softball. For Bob Hamilton on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. Once again, the final score for the final time, the Hopkinton Hillers take down the Bellingham Blackhawks 3-1. They finish the season 19-1 overall, 18-0 in the TVL. The first time in recent history the Hillers have gone undefeated in the TVL. Both teams will head to the playoffs. The Hopkinton Hillers, what a tremendous season they have had. That'll wrap up this coverage of Hillers softball for the regular season games. When we next talk to you, it'll be playoff time. Once again, for Bob Hamilton on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for watching Hillers softball on HCAM.
Tom Nappy here with Kayla Sullivan. Kayla, how does it feel to be undefeated in the TVL this season?
It feels awesome. My team worked really hard, and we had an awesome season all around, top to bottom, and I think we deserved it.
And you've had a tremendous season with the bat, the league leader in batting average, most likely going to be the MVP. Just talk about this season and how have you managed to keep up that type of batting average all year long? It's just incredible what you've done at the plate.
I don't know. I've had a lot of confidence from my team behind me, and when they get on, it gives me momentum to get myself on. And I've just, I don't even know. I guess it's worked. So I've had a pretty good season myself, yes.
And could you talk about the atmosphere here today, the final game of the year, big game against Bellingham, the Baker Bowl. The first time you met up with these guys, it was a close game, a 3-2 game. Just talk about the atmosphere, and obviously this game had all the dramatics of a typical Baker Bowl.
To us, well, we won the league at the last game, so like to us this game like meant nothing in that aspect, but it meant so much to us because like we were going undefeated and we know Baker always loves to beat his dad. It's just something that he enjoys doing because he's always grown up and his dad's, he always talks about how his dad gives him no mercy. So it's something we like to do for him, and we had a lot of confidence going into today's game.
Now, more than likely, this game doesn't make too much of a difference with seeding, but was there that extra push knowing that you guys are playing Bellingham today?
Yeah, we always love to play Bellingham. We always know it's their toughest game of the season, so when we came out today, we were hoping to get that win to push us up to maybe first or second in the states.
So are you going to be anxious for Monday when the brackets come out?
Yeah, I think there's only one other team out there from last I heard that was undefeated at the time, and they have a few more games, so it's either going to be a coin flip with them, or we'll see, but hopefully we should get a bye through the first round, which will be nice. It'll be a nice rest for us.
All right, well, congratulations on a terrific season, and hopefully we'll be following you for a long time in the playoffs.
Thank you.
All right, I'm here with Juliet Hulme, another gem out there by you. A little nerve-wracking, of course, towards the end, but a typical game versus Bellingham. Tell us how everything went out there today.
It went great. I mean, letting up a home run in the first inning was definitely the most nerve-wracking part, but if I didn't let up home runs, I had complete confidence in my defense, and I had complete confidence that if I tired out or got hurt, that the second pitcher, Bree Mirabli, would come in and do just as good a job as I could.
And you haven't given up a run since the last time you played Bellingham, so certainly the home run in the first was, I think, a shock to really everybody, but can you just talk about the season overall and how it feels to be undefeated in the TVL?
Oh, it feels so great. I can't even describe it. We had such a great season. We were just improving the entire time. We're such a close team. We all like each other, and I think that's a big part of this.
I remember the last time we talked, you said that you're going to try to go undefeated in the TVL and you really think you could do it. Well, you certainly have proven to everybody that you were right. And are you excited for these playoff brackets to come out? You're going to get a couple home games. What are you looking to do in the playoffs this season?
I'm excited for the playoffs because I know it's going to be even tougher competition, so we'll have to play even harder. I'm looking to make a run in the tournament, maybe win a state.
Absolutely. Now, 14 strikeouts against a tough Bellingham lineup today, and you make it look easier than it really is, but can you talk about how tough it is to face this lineup?
It is really tough. They're such good hitters. I mean, they can hit any pitch that I throw, so it's always nerve-wracking. I always really have to think about where to put the ball, never right down the middle. It's tough.
Well, certainly. Well, best of luck in the playoffs, and thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
All right, I'm here with head coach of the Hopkinton Hillers softball team, Dennis Baker Jr. Coach, you guys are undefeated in the TVL. How does it feel?
It feels great. I'm so proud of the girls, the effort they, you know, not only today, but all year. I'm so confident in this group of girls. And we knew we had a special team coming into the year. You saw us last year, how good we were. A lot of returning players. But you can never count on going undefeated. You know, it's
especially
just,
in this division.
Yeah, it's a tough league. It's a tough division. So, you know, Bellingham, Norton, Medfield's a good team. So it's something that I haven't seen happen in a while. Bellingham was state champions last year. They didn't make it through the Tri-Valley League undefeated. So it's an unbelievable accomplishment, and it's a once-in-a-lifetime thing. I've been coaching for 15 years in this league, and I've never been a part of a league that's even had an undefeated team before. So for the girls to do that, I'm just so proud of them, and I'm so happy for them.
Now, we have to go back in the archives, but this could be the first time in TVL history. We're not quite sure on that. That's something we're going to research. But this is a rare accomplishment. It's something that you mentioned that your dad hasn't even done. He's won the state championship but hasn't done this. So is there going to be a little bragging going on?
Well, I think a little bit. I can't help but be proud of what we did. And I think, you know, although he's probably disappointed today, he would have liked to have spoiled it. I'm sure he's proud of what we have done. But you know, it really is. It's almost like a state championship in a way. It's something that happens so rarely. So I'm going to have to brag a little bit about it, I think. But I'm going to give all the credit to the girls, of course.
Oh, absolutely. Now, Juliet Hulme gave up a home run in the first inning. It was one of the most rarest things you'll ever see. When that happened, what were you thinking there?
Well, it was a shock. We've rarely seen a hard hit ball against Juliet this year, never mind the number two batter taking her deep. And I'd be lying if I didn't say in the back of my head, oh, is today the day that maybe she just doesn't have it? Or maybe winning the league the other day, we all kind of exhale and let down a little bit. So I had that a little bit in my head, just in the back, the very, very back. But I think it kind of woke her up a little bit. I think it did. I think after that, the second, she got stronger as the game went on today. Second, third inning, that same girl had a rocket single, maybe again in the third, and I think that was pretty much it for them for the day. She really focused after that and pitched a tremendous ball game. So, it was one of those things that I think she used it to her advantage today, giving up a home run early to kind of refocus her.
Yeah, it was only two hits she gave up, and she does seem to get stronger a lot as the game's going on, maybe struggle a little bit in the early innings, throw more balls than not, but get better as the game went on. But then she had 14 strikeouts. Can you just talk about her performance all season long? Certainly has to be one of the most dominant pitchers that you've seen, really, maybe even in the state in a while.
She's been the best pitcher I've seen. And I remember having an interview with you. We talked over on Fruit Street on a cold day with 3 feet of snow surrounding us. And I said that she was capable of doing some special things. I don't know if we expected that it would be this special, but I mean, her stats are just mind blowing. This is only the second earned run she's given up in, I think, 70 innings this year. She averages maybe one hit every 3 or 4 innings. Her control has been great. Even though she works deep into a lot of counts, she doesn't walk a lot of hitters. So she's pitching some pressure situations too, with runners on, runners in scoring position late in the game. And she just has this focus about her. I feel better when I look out on the mound and I see the focus in her eyes. It calms me down a little bit, so I'm really happy that she's able to do that. And she's had this coming for a long time. She's been a great pitcher, and not a lot of people have realized how good she is. So for her to do this her senior year, I'm so proud and I'm so happy for her.
Well, you must be anxious for the playoff seedings to come out. Any idea where you'll be? Obviously, you'll be at home, but against...
I don't know yet. I believe we're going to be a number one or a number two seed at 19-1. It's a very strong bracket, Division I South. It's the best softball in the state. There's 10 teams, us included. I think any one of the 10 teams could win a South sectional. And, it's going to be a great challenge, but we're really looking forward to it. I think we got a lot of experience last year from making a deep state tournament run, and I think we're going to rely on that experience. We are going to enjoy this for a little while. The Absolutely. Seedings come out Monday, so we'll enjoy it tomorrow, maybe give ourselves the weekend, and then once we find out where we're going to play or who we're going to play on Monday, we'll kind of refocus and put this behind us.
Well, you guys certainly deserve to have a little bit of enjoyment. What a tremendous season. Congratulations to you and the team, and we hope that there are many more playoff games to come.
Thank you very much.